Hello everybody, this is Angie, and I have another fun project that you could make with your family, and it is pretty frugal, as a matter of fact, because you get a free template off of the internet, so even if you're in another country, if you could get the paper, you can get this template because it's on the internet. But I made this little carrot. Oops, it's stuck in a basket. This little carrot saver box, candy box, and I will come back and give you information on how I made it, made the leaves too, and I will be right back. Now, I found this template a long time ago. I've been having it in my computer because I saved it, and you can find it also. All you have to do is go to Google and put in carrot box template. And pull down the one that looks like this. And it is so easy to use because it's incredibly easy to fold and everything. They even give you the guidelines here because all the dotted lines are where you fold. And, of course, the outline is the only part that you actually cut. But look for carrot box template on Google. And you could pull this down no matter what country you live in. The only thing, of course, you need to find is the paper. And a long time ago, and I know you hear me talk about these packs a lot, I bought this neutral pack, and of all things, it had the orange, and I thought, I'm never going to use that orange. Little did I know that that's the one I use a lot. But anyway, I printed it directly onto the paper to make it easier on myself, and I've already cut one out so you can see just how easy it is. I did use my ruler to help me fold because all I did was place the ruler on each of these dotted lines and start to fold it with my ruler, and that gave me a good way to start getting into those fold lines. So this is what you have with your template, and this is how easy it goes together. Now, I'm not going to glue all this on camera, but I will show you the box that I made because it's so easy. You just glue this side and then these two little flaps. Now, you can make this in different ways, but the way I did it was I put these two flaps down, these two corner flaps down, and then these down, and it pretty much folds in on itself. You might have to trim a little bit off the top if you're going to make it that way, which is what I did. Because there's another way you could do it, and that is to fold it this way and put the little green, if you want to make a carrot, add the little green strips, you know, to make it go up. But I did not do that. I did fold in the sides, tuck that. Of course, you're going to put your things in first, your candies or your favors or little toys for the kids, whatever you're going to do. And then you wind up with this very neat box. Now, that was the easy part. That was a real easy part. Your creativity comes into play if you want to make a different top, which I made. Now, I did see this idea on Pinterest, but it was from Sizzix, and they had a machine called the Eclipse, and they use like two different cartridges, so I knew I could get the carrot box, and I kind of knew I could kind of make this kind of this top, and it took me a while to figure it out, but it does kind of look like three-leaved clovers or propellers with hearts on them or just elongated hearts. And what I did was I drew it very much in the raw like that, and then cut them out and use those as my template to make two. And what you do is you can put your fingernail right in the middle, right where that indentation is, and kind of turn it in a bit to make the little top stand up. And you could do this very easily with cardstock. If you put your finger here and your fingernail here and curl, try to curl it a bit so that it does stand up. And you do that with both. And then I glued them together, put them like that, and still you could work with it. And then I pasted them on the top. Again, you could pull them up. Once you glue them on the top like that, you know, put them in this way so that you have leaves on all the sides. Once you do that, you could start to pull them up. And they do sit up with your cardstock once you start working with it like that. I do like the darker green. Anyway, I know this was a quickie. I didn't do everything on camera, mainly because I'm just a little bit clumsy right now with my hand-to-eye coordination. But if you like this idea, try it out, because you do get the template for free. It's so much fun. And if you don't want to take the time, or if this is not to your liking, you could always make the little boxes and then cut your green strips to make it look like the way the carrots come out. You know, they pull them with the strips in the front. So I know this was a quick video, but just very quick idea on how you can make these. And let's see. I think I answered my own questions. But if you have any questions, please feel free to jot them down there, and I will be happy to answer them. And this is Angie. I am wishing you a wonderful creative day. Bye now.